Could Grok3 be the smartest available AI today? That's exactly what we're exploring in this video. Unlike other AI tools, Grok3 has real-time access to X, formerly known as Twitter, and deep research technology, giving it a massive advantage into finding insights that other AI tools might completely miss. Over the next 10 minutes, I'm going to show you 7 mind-blowing ways how Grok3 is transforming content creation, website building, and data analysis. Just wait until we get to number 5. That one honestly surprised me. Before we get started, this is your chance to get ahead. I've condensed my entire YouTube growth system into a 40-minute course that takes out the guesswork and gives you fast, predictable results. The special launch bonus is first come, first served. Click the link in the description below before the spots are filled. And if you're serious about AI, subscribe to stay ahead. All right, let's get into Grok3. This AI is seriously changing the game. So what sets it apart from ChatGPT, Claude, or Gemini? Well, besides having real-time access to X, it can handle everything from complex math problems to on-the-spot research with impressive accuracy. It also has Think Mode, which breaks down complex problems step by step, which can be very helpful. Now let's talk about its search capabilities. DeepSearch is crazy fast and great when you need quick, straightforward answers, and deeper search when your questions require more thorough explanations. Let's test DeepSearch first. I'm going to ask Grok3 for the latest advancements in AI-powered text-to-video generation tools, and it should come up with a list of features and recommendations. It just needed 48 seconds to come up with quite a thorough analysis of 3 tools that it recommends: Synthesia, Runway, and Pika Labs. Synthesia is definitely the best tool for video generation right now, although it's great for enterprise. So it also included these use cases, which is super helpful. So what I really like about it is that it's very thorough and way more sophisticated compared to what I usually get from Perplexity. But just to compare, let's explore now deeper search. I'll go for a more sophisticated prompt and I'll ask Grok3 for a breakdown of how AI-powered text-to-video tools evolved in 2025. This is going to take considerably longer than deeper search. It already scanned 65 sources that I can check on the right side. Overall, it took 2 minutes and 33 seconds, which is quite fast for this functionality. So in 2025, text-to-video became more realistic and easier to use. I get a breakdown of the main technical advancements and the key breakthroughs in detail, and also a comparative analysis of the top leading tools, which is very helpful if I'm thinking of trying out one of these. So it's like you get a detailed research report. Moving on to use case number 2, which is image generation. I'm going to ask Grok3 to generate an image of a watermelon that I can use for an ad. That's a really good result. I mean, look at the texture, at how the sun falls into the watermelon. Now let's try something a little bit more difficult where other AI tools might give you trouble. I'm going to ask it to create an image with a celebrity, and this time I want the watermelon to be cut open. Oh, wow, that's a fantastic start. I mean, look at the details and the colors of the image. And while ChatGPT flat out refuses to generate images of celebrities, Grok3 delivers without hesitation. The quality is also fantastic. I mean, it looks very real. Let's move on to the next use case, which is Grok3's writing abilities. I will ask for an SEO-optimized blog post about the topic AI versus human, and I will give it a sample of my writing style so it can hopefully adjust the text better. What's great about it is you can immediately see what keywords were in focus. And if I wanted to, I could add specific ones in my own prompt as well. Now, when I read through the text, I can definitely see that it sounds more human-like compared to the output that I generally get from ChatGPT. I can now go into ZeroGPT and check what kind of AI score the text will get. Oh, wow, 8% AI generated. That's very impressive. Imagine the possibilities. That means you can create high-quality blog posts at scale without worrying about AI penalties. Let's move on to the next use case, which is cloning a website. Imagine the following scenario. You need to build a website and you don't want to start from scratch. What if you could take a screenshot of an existing website and let AI generate the code for you? Let's try it. I'll go for a Bravo's website, which is an email provider. As a first step, I'll screenshot the website.
And what I'll also do, I'll view the page source and I'll copy the code. And then first add the prompt. I will add the code. And I'll activate think mode because it just works better for coding. It first goes through an analysis of the website. It even comes up with strengths and weaknesses, which is super fun. Let's take a look at the website. So when I compare it overall, obviously the design here is more sophisticated, but it is quite similar. And the pricing comparison is here also very nice. Feature and automation capabilities is also very similar. Obviously, I could look for pictures that I'd like to integrate on the website and chat to Grok3 about it, but at least it gives you a fantastic base that you can build upon. So what if I want something that's completely new? I'll ask Grok3 to generate a complete landing page for me, including headlines, benefit section, testimonials, pricing tables, and psychological triggers that drive conversions. Overall, it needed 84 seconds to generate the landing page. Let's have a look. So the headline could definitely be stronger. It's a little bit generic. I do like that it uses social proof here. There's a benefit section, testimonial section, pricing, and a 30-day money-back guarantee. So overall, the flow is not bad, but it could be definitely more specific, and the design is extremely basic. So let's see if we can improve the design. So overall, it needed a minute to improve the website. Let's first take a look at the argumentation, what changed. So the headline is definitely more specific. The benefits were updated. Testimonials are more specific, save 2 hours a day. Efficiency jumped by 30%. Let's see. The design of the website looks a little bit better compared to before, but in order to get it to a place where I would say that it resonates with me, I'd probably have to make screenshots of elements and input them into Grok3. But overall, I could literally input a couple of screenshots of elements that I like, customize a code to my own branding, and then have something up and running in a couple of hours, which is fantastic. Moving on to use case number 6, a lead generation quiz. Imagine you're running a lead generation campaign and you want to design a quiz in order to engage potential customers. I'm asking Grok3 to create a What's Your AI Readiness Score quiz with 5 questions, with built-in scoring, insightful result categories, and email capture functionality that integrates with the popular email marketing platforms. What's pretty amazing about the output is that it already pre-coded the questions for me without me having to type in a separate prompt. So here I can just see how it works, the questions, how the answers are being assigned, the scoring logic. And here I can see that the API integration works with MailChimp, HubSpot, ConvertKit. So let's have a look. The quiz has clearly been designed from a B2B perspective, but overall, I think that the questions are actually quite good. How your organization handles data, how open your organization is adapting to new technologies. So let's see if this also works properly. So that button doesn't work. Let's see if Grok can fix it. Okay, I will test now the new form. So I see that it's not working again. Here I can also find an explanation on how to test it. So I should actually save the code and open it up in a new browser. And what I love about it is that it immediately troubleshoots with you. So it gives you a couple of options in case that's still not working. So I'll open up one compiler and run the code in there. Let's try it again. I can see that this time it really works, which is fantastic. That brings me to my last use case, extracting insights from data. Sometimes if you're working with these big data sets, it can take a lot of time to extract the right insights, especially when it comes to customer behavior insights, ad performance data, funnel performance data. So I'm going to import a big data set on the funnel performance of a video sales letter, and I'll ask Grok3 to find trends and insights that I might have missed. I get all kinds of insights about my data. So apparently my click-through rate averages about 5% And I get also some suggestions for improvement to optimize ad creative, check my audience segmentation, A/B test my copy, which is like very standard. So I can just really get a better understanding about how my leads are behaving. For example, here I get to see that 50 to 70% of my leads are actually qualified, which is overall not a bad percentage. So I can now really start chatting more with the data and find out what my best performing channel is, how to improve my overall conversions, and spot these types of patterns considerably faster. And what I'm going to do now is I'll ask it to visualize the data, because generally I'm a very visual person. And I find that's much easier to spot insights in graphs. I'll just confirm that I want to generate an image. That's a fantastic simple graph that can already help me to make decisions. Like, I'll probably invest more money into paid social, pay-per-click, and I'll probably stop doing podcast ads because the deals are just considerably smaller. You can also ask Grok3 to even code these graphics for you, so you get more sophisticated images. This really gives me a competitive edge over people who are still doing things the old-fashioned way.
So there you have it. 7 game-changing ways how Grok3 is redefining what's possible with AI. Speaking of powerful AI tools, if you like this video, you're going to love the one right over here, where I walk you through 4 different use cases of DeepSeek that have completely transformed my own workflow. I'll see you there.